Data is a new gold. AI is trained on data and companies make data-driven decisions. By doing something called web scraping, you can extract and store data from a website. Then you can use this data for data analysis or other purposes. It's incredibly useful and you can add a lot of value, which is why this skill is so useful for any data analyst. If you know this, you're instantly more likely to get a job. Also, this video is in partnership with Listly, a free no-coding web scraper, but we'll get into that in a second. In this video, I'll explain how web scraping works in simple terms and then show you how to scrape data easily, because the way we do things is changing. The honest truth is that you don't even need to code anymore. Web scraping is an automated method used to extract vast amounts of data from websites. Data on websites is unstructured, and web scraping enables us to convert that data into a structured form. For example, you could store the data in a spreadsheet. Web scraping is a bit like having a helpful robot doing all the hard work of collecting, organizing the information for you. This technology is not new. In fact, web scraping has its roots in the early days of the internet when data extraction was more like a manual task. Fast forward to today, web scraping is an integral part of data-driven decision-making. It's being used across industries for a multitude of purposes. For example, imagine if you're offering a data analysis service, you could use web scraping to gather contact information from relevant businesses to whom you could sell your services to, thereby saving you lots of hours of manual searching. But as the saying goes, with great power comes great responsibility. Web scraping in itself is absolutely not illegal, but it can sometimes be a gray area. Some websites have guidelines about what data you can and cannot scrape in their terms of service. Privacy laws and regulations can also affect what data is permissible to scrape and store, particularly when it comes to personal data. For example, according to GDPR in the European Union. So I was actually contacted by a company called Listly and they wanted me to try their web scraping tool. Now I checked it out and I found it absolutely amazing and I decided to partner up with them. So thank you Listly for sponsoring this video. Listly is an incredible browser extension that automates the web scraping process, saving you time and effort. It does not even require any coding. You can just scrape the page right away. It's actually like having your personal web scraping assistant. The best part, you can get started with Listly for free, and it's actually free forever. They're free plan is incredibly powerful, packing in all the essential features that you'll need. So instead of just talking about it, I'll show you how easy web scraping becomes in this new era using this free web scraping tool. Alright, so now I'm going to show you how to actually use this to scrape data from a real website. We're going to be using a website called AliExpress, and it's like a retail site. They have lots of different products in different areas, as you can see, consumer products in general. Now I'm going to show you how to scrape some data for this. And this is essentially a very like unstructured format, because the data is not in an Excel sheet or something like that. It's on a website, and the website is also kind of messy, so you know it's going to be a challenge depending on what you want to do with it. But I'm going to show you how you can use Listly. So the first thing that you're going to do is you're going to click here and you want to sign in to Listly. So now I signed in, and what I'm going to do, as you can see, I'm on the free plan as well. What you want to do is you want to click, for example, if you want to select the entire page. Now if you want to do that, that's amazing, but if you do click this button, it's essentially going to take all the data on the page. It's very useful if you have a specific page that you want to scrape, but in this case there's no purpose in keeping all of the data and it's just going to be a real mess. So what we're going to do is we're actually going to take a part of it. We're going to click Listly part. Now I don't have any real specific goal with this, but let's say that we want to collect some of these different products with their pricing and their actual name. Now you could be very specific. You could take a specific product manually, but let's say we want all of these products in this section. What we're going to do is we're going to select this section like this, and we're going to let it essentially run. Now Listly is going to do the work for us, and this is where the really cool part comes in. This is the AliExpress, and we have the part, and we can download it as a few different things. Also, if you do have the paid version, you can actually get access to the API and things like that. But for now, we're only going to be using the free version, and that's definitely enough. So here you can see that quick view of the things that we actually scraped, and it looks pretty good. It's the items that we wanted, like it's the basic things. Some issues will occur, of course, because you know it's scraping data, but you can be more specific with your instructions and it can do a better job. It's important to know that you're going to have to clean this data and you're going to have to prepare it in a way that works for your analysis or for whatever you want to do with it. For now, we're just going to be downloading it. So here you can see the data in a spreadsheet. Is everything going to be perfect? Absolutely not, because this was just a really quick example of a pretty difficult site that we also really had no specific objective with this except just get the basic info. We did actually get that. We got a label, as you can see here, the every product. We also got the price. Now I'm not sure exactly what these things mean. Could, for example, be a sale or something like the original price. I'm not sure what these labels mean. And you would just essentially keep the columns that you need. You would try to structure this up in a way that is good for you. And then you could actually start working with this. And as you can see, the cool part is that you can actually get this right into Excel or Sheets. There are also a lot of premium features that make it way easier to scrape data from the web, but I do recommend that you sign up for the free plan first, and then you can just upgrade whenever you need these amazing features. So just head to Chrome extensions and then add Listly to your browser, or just head to listly.io to get started creating a free account. Web scraping isn't actually that complicated when it comes to coding either. I mean, you don't have to be an expert at programming to scrape some data, for example using Python, but the thing that web scrapers like Listly do so well is that it makes it much faster and just way easier in general. Am I saying manual web scraping is dead? No, but the purpose of using programming languages to scrape the web was just to make it more efficient than doing it by hand. And now we can make it even more efficient than programming, we can do it with a browser extension. There are still many scenarios where I would use Python, for example, and it's still great to learn that. But in general, not using Listly is crazy because it's a free, awesome tool that's gonna save you a lot of time. There are also websites like Scrape This Site where you can actually just practice web scraping in a pretty friendly environment. And if you can see in their sandbox, they have a few different things. We can just see if our web scraper works for this. So we have a lot of different countries here. So we're gonna click on Listly. We're gonna see what it does. Now, obviously, you have to be as specific as you want to, but in this case, we're just going to do everything very, very like basic. No, I did actually click the wrong thing, but let's see if that works. I think it actually scraped the entire thing. Let's see what happens if we do this. All right, so basically what happened is that all the data of the specific countries look like this, and they have the area, population, capital, and then the country. You could get this into some other format. I'm not sure how this is going to look when we get the Excel file. Let's take a look. All right, so this is how it actually looks like. I think this looks really, really good. Now, you would have obviously remove a few columns, but as you can see right here, like this is the actual country, the capital, the population, the area, and a couple of other ones that didn't really fit because there were actually two columns. So what I would do is I would probably move these ones down there. As you can see, like, it just saves a lot of time. It did most of the work for us in just one single click. If you're just doing the basic stuff like most people are, you're gonna be just fine with the free plan. And that's why I feel so confident about recommending it to you. If you feel like insecure about the privacy and things like that, you could just create a separate profile in Chrome, and then all your data is 100% secure that you only use for web scraping. The purpose of this video was just to really show you that web scraping is changing. Now, of course, should you learn to code, should you learn to do web scraping? Of course. But eventually, if you're going to be using it in a practical sense, it might be really efficient to start using something like this. And that's why I just wanted to keep you up to date on what's actually going on in the web scraping industry. So that's pretty much it. Thank you guys for watching this video. Make sure to install Listly for free in your browser, and then I'll see you in the next video.